2020 has certainly been a unique and challenging year for us all, but the Oxygen team persevered and we are very proud to announce the release of Oxygen 23, the most powerful and comprehensive version of the Oxygen suite of products to date. Here are some of the highlights of the most requested and exciting new features. As always, we focused a lot of attention on requests submitted by the ever-expanding DITA community to make the authoring experience in Oxygen even more efficient and dynamic. For example, a new option called Allow Reference Submaps to be Edited can be enabled in the DITA Maps Preferences page. And after reopening the DITA map, you now have the ability to edit submaps directly in the DITA Maps Manager view without needing to open them in their own tab. Similarly, a new option called Allow Reference Content to be Edited can be enabled in the Author Preferences page. And this means that when you use the Open Map in Editor with Resolve Topics button from the DITA Maps Manager's toolbar, the DITA map is opened in the main editor with the content from all reference topics expandable and editable directly in the editor. A new option was also added in the DITA Preferences page to enable DITA 2.0 editing support. This, for instance, makes it possible to create DITA 2.0 maps and topics from the new document wizard. Oxygen now includes a dynamic feature where certain editing events will trigger a floating toolbar with common editing actions that are available in the current context. This increases your productivity by making your DITA editing experience even more efficient. On the DITA publishing side, you now have the ability to run multiple DITA OT or ANT transformation scenarios simultaneously. This helps to reduce the amount of time it takes the publishing engine to finish transforming large projects. After configuring the transformation scenarios however you like, when more than one is selected in the configuration dialog box, you then have access to a new option to run the transformations in parallel. Image maps are now fully supported in CSS-based PDF output. When configuring the DITA map to PDF based on HTML5 and CSS transformation scenario, you now have access to a few new parameters that instruct the publishing engine to show the shapes and numbers over the top of the published image. In the output, the shapes and numbers are rendered as clickable areas within the image, and the list of links are presented below it. The development team continued to integrate and improve various add-ons that extend Oxygen's functionality. A vast amount of improvements and new features have been added to the Git client since the last major release. One example is a new toolbar button that opens the Git Branch Manager side view. It presents all the local and remote branches as a tree. You can double-click to switch to that branch, and various actions were added to the contextual menu to make it very easy to check out branches and to create or delete branches. A brand new terminology checker add-on is now available. You can create a terminology file with a set of rules for each term, and flagged terms are displayed in a terminology helper view. This view offers some contextual menu actions for replacing the highlighted content, and flag terms are also highlighted in the main editor pane where an inline drop-down menu offers proposals for replacing the term. Another new add-on is available that provides support for helping translators. It provides access to a contextual menu action to show the current content in a translator helper side view. You can then replace the content in the editor pane with translated content and compare them side by side. Oxygen's implementation of the Diff and Merge support in the Eclipse plugin now includes a text-based mode. There are several ways to trigger a comparison, and you can even do a three-way comparison if a common ancestor exists. It automatically opens the comparison in the visual mode, but there is now a toolbar button for switching to the text-based mode, and it has the same features and options that are available in the file comparison tool included in the standalone version of Oxygen. As usual, we did not forget about our JSON users. You can now edit JSON and JSON schema documents in the Visual Author Editing mode, and you have access to various features and actions that are available for XML documents. For example, it has content completion and validation support. You can use form controls or inline editing widgets. And you can query properties and values using XPath expressions. Oxygen also now includes a handy tool for generating documentation for a JSON schema file. Once you specify the path to the JSON schema and the output file path, documentation is then generated in HTML format. A variety of exciting new features were added for the innovative online Oxygen XML web author. Over the past few years, one of the most requested features from web author users has been the ability for teams to edit and review content concurrently. You can share your editing session by sending its URL to other collaborators, and then you and your colleagues can edit and review the same document simultaneously. The concurrent editing session continues as long as you keep the document open and the person who originally shared the session is the only one who can save the document. A new option was added in the DITA Map Display Mode drop-down menu to edit topic content. The DITA Map is then displayed with its content from all reference topics expanded, and you can edit the reference content directly. Web Author now includes a dynamic feature where certain editing events will trigger a floating toolbar. It includes editing actions that are available in the current editing context, and this increases your productivity by giving you easier access to the most common editing and styling actions. You now have the ability to transform Web Author content to PDF. Oxygen PDF Chemistry is used behind the scenes to produce the PDF, and it is customizable using CSS. You can now copy content from Web Author and paste it into an external application, and the HTML structure is preserved. It is now easier to open links within documents simply by using the Ctrl-click shortcut. And it opens the link in a new browser tab. Support was added for Bitbucket server integrations. You can commit changes to your document to your Bitbucket repository. And after a successful commit, you then have the option to view it on the Bitbucket server. These were just some of the most highly anticipated new features added in version 23. For a complete list of all the additions, updates, and implementations, go to our What's New page on our website.